Okay, hi everyone. In today's video, I will be creating a Korean dish. It's called spicy cold chewy noodles or spicy chewy cold noodles. There's actually a variety of there's many, you know, Korean spicy cold noodles, but today I'm making the chewy one. It's called jeolmyeon. I don't know. I think it's really popular during summer. I'm not very sure. But I could be wrong, so anyways, I've been craving it and I kept thinking how I could make this more fun and more interesting, and I will show you guys different, I guess, methods of adding ingredients and different types of ingredients that you could add to really fully enjoy this dish. And right here I'm making egg drop soup or egg soup or gaeranguk, whatever you want to call it. I'm not sure, should I make that first? Yeah, I think I should make this first. So, okay, so I actually pre-boiled mine just because I didn't want it to take too long and waste the gas here. So you could use like a regular water, or if you have any like anchovy stock or regular chicken stock, any kind of anything besides water, you could use it. But you know, honestly, it doesn't really matter. Okay. Okay, so I let it boil for a little bit. I'm actually using two eggs. Oops. Okay. My table is so hollow. So it wasn't. Oh my god! Did I tell you? So when I was moving, I was using my mom's SUV. And this was the first thing that went inside the car because, you know, it's the biggest, and I thought I could just put it in the bottom. And as I was moving things in, I was actually in the car, like my entire, like, you know, whole, I was physically like in the car. And as I was like moving around, like my knee goes through this table, like my knee goes through this entire table, and I think right there or I don't know, it's like right around there. There's like a huge hole where my knee went through. And I was like, oh my god, am I this fat? Like, am I this, did I gain that much weight? It doesn't have to be fully beaten, just somewhat. And I'm going to add scallion in here. Water is boiling. I'm just going to, you know, like, drop it in there. Until the egg is cooked a little, I wouldn't stir this because you want to have the egg and the soup separate, and you would have more clear soup instead of, like, you know, having like a foggy, cloudy soup. I'm gonna let that sit there, boil more. And then I am going to add some onions. I'm using a lot of vegetables today, which is good because I love vegetables. No one believes me, but I really do. Okay. I'm going to add some onions. Stir it all together. That's really easy, right? And then on top of it, I'm going to use the red peppers. Ooh, these are really spicy and expensive. I'm just gonna put it. I don't know, you can't see it here. And then I'm gonna just close it, turn it off, and I will reboil it when I'm about to eat it. I wanna keep it hot. Okay, that one's done. So easy, right? So I have, let's make the spicy noodle, let's make the sauce for the chewy noodles. I have some pepper paste, pepper flakes, sesame seeds, sugar, soy sauce, vinegar, and this is capsaicin. I'm not sure if many people will know, but this sauce is really, really, really spicy, like too spicy. I think this is spicier than the super spicy noodles. So if you really enjoy that, I'm going to add a little bit. Honestly, you can't even put like one full tablespoon. It has to be like I don't know, like, I'm gonna do, like, a pinch of it. Okay. Yeah, okay. I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of pepper paste. So this pepper flakes can be optional. You could add it if you want it spicy. I'm gonna maybe add like one. So from now on, I'm going to say just numbers to explain, to show you guys the ratio of ingredients instead of giving you the exact measurement. Okay. And then I'm going to add a little bit of sugar. Some people don't, some people do. I like my sweet, so like another one. Much sugar is something that you could add more later. So okay. And then going to add one to two. Soy sauce. Depends on how salty you want it. Let's add. Oh my god, it's gonna be so spicy. Like, when I was at a restaurant, when I was working, one of our sous chef, he actually brought it. He's like, oh, try it. It's really, really good. So I tried like, I think a teaspoon of it. Oh my gosh, I thought I was gonna die. But not just that much. And people who thought they were really good at taking spicy food, they tried it and they're like, oh, it's not that bad. It's not that bad. And like literally 5 minutes later, they're like, oh my gosh, give me water. Every single person, I never saw a person trying this capsaicin sauce and said it's not spicy, because there's no freaking way. Anyways, and the most important part about this sauce and what, because you guys know, like, a lot of Korean food, a lot of Korean spicy sauces are based off of the pepper paste, but what makes this sauce different is the vinegar. I'm going to add about 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want to add a little bit more sugar. I want my sweet. That much. Let's see. Oh my god, it's spicy. Let's make the ingredients. So I have some cabbage, thinly cut cabbage, and some bean sprouts. Right? These are bean sprouts. And I have cucumber and what is this? Carrots, which I will use this thing that is supposed to make every vegetable into a spaghetti noodle. So let's see how it works. I'm using the thinner side. Oh, look at that. That is so neat. Oh my gosh. This is so cool. Easy to use. This is cool, I really like it. Okay, maybe just a little bit more. Cool. Okay, that one's done. You know, if your dog is teething and if you are trying to get him some like kind of toy or like a bone for you could chew on instead of chewing your furniture, it can be really expensive, you know. So, but what I used to do, or I still do it sometimes, you just freeze a carrot in the refrigerator, and if you give it to them, it kind of works. They, like, my dog got sick of it. He stopped eating it. He realized the carrot tastes really bad, so he stopped using it. But it's like a good try. If you, and who knows, your dog really might like the carrot. Okay, and then some cucumber. Ooh, this might turn out really nice. Yummy. Oh my gosh, I used to do so much, like, I looked up so many things. What's the other thing? I don't know if I want to use this part. When my dog used to teach, oh my gosh, he used to, I went through so many chargers, my furnitures were bitten off, and he literally chewed everything in my house, and I tried everything. I put salt on it, I put lemon juice on it, I put olive oil on it. I did everything, but you know what? It's so funny because when he went for it and realized it tastes like it's salty or it's sour, he stops and he comes back later. He goes for it and he licks it up. He goes through with it. Like, he knows it's sour. He knows it tastes bad, but he licks everything up and he starts chewing again. I'm like, wow, you are stubborn. What I ended up doing was I just had nothing on the floor. I didn't leave anything on the floor, and eventually he grew out of it. So that's good. So this is my chewy noodle bowl, and I already pre-boiled the chewy noodles, and I left it with some ice and some sesame oil in here so it wouldn't stick together. Okay. I don't know if I can eat all of this. So I'm gonna start off with that much for now. Okay. And then I'm going to add the carrots. Oh my god, this is so much. Cucumber, some bean sprouts, some cabbage. Okay, so put that on the side. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm not sure if a lot of people are familiar with this, but this is called korbangi or bay top shell. Yeah, this really tastes good with any kind of like spicy dish. And I don't have to wash it because I have seen many people just eating off out of the can, so I'm gonna take some out right here. Just a couple pieces. I don't know, I feel like a lot of people will be like disgusted by this, but it's actually really, really good. Especially when you're drinking. Oh my gosh, these are the best. I'm actually just going to add a little bit. Put it on this side. So it looks like that so far. It looks good, right? And then finally I have some dumplings. I'm only gonna add a couple on the side. I feel like I'm not even gonna be able to mix this. Okay. Ta-da! Looks like that. You know what I didn't make? I didn't make eggs. Boiled eggs. But anyways, I want to add maybe like 3 tablespoons on top. For now. And then top it off with some sesame seeds. Yum. But you know what? It's okay. I have the egg soup, so that makes up for it. I'm going to season it with some salt and pepper. Pepper and salt. Should be good. Yay. Let's eat. You guys see this? Oh my gosh, looks so good, right? Egg soup. Now, this is the hard part of mixing everything in together. Maybe I can use more sauce. Oh my gosh. There's so much. Looks so spicy, I don't even know. Let's try it with some vegetables. Where are all the vegetables? Where's my dumplings? Oh my gosh. It's so spicy. I don't know what it is, but I keep blowing into my noodles when it's like not even hot. It's like a habit. Oh, this is so spicy. So good though. I burnt it a little. Oops. I'm just the burn part out. Oh my god, this is so good, but it's so spicy. Some dumplings. For today's drink, I have, this is called shikhae or rice water, rice drink. I don't know, what's it called? It's just really, really sweet. And there's like rice grains on the bottom, which I don't like, so I don't like to shake it. But if you are eating something spicy, like try it with this. It will really, really help. But as you can see, this is new. I haven't even opened it and it's impossible. I'm so impatient because my mouth is burning right now. Oh my god. Okay, I'm here. Wait, was that it? Okay. Oh. Ooh, that is spicy. But it's so good. Not gonna lie, it's pretty good. I like it. I like it a lot. Mmm. Yep, needed that. I feel like I don't have enough vegetables in here with my leftover cabbage. Maybe that'll work. Oh, so hot. I made it worse. My mouth is burning. I need more dumplings. Oh, that's so spicy. See, I don't know why I'm doing it. I don't know why I'm acting like it's hot. So earlier I asked you guys what you guys would like me to talk about. Oh yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, so this I asked you guys what you guys would like me to talk about on Instagram, and many people gave me what they want me to eat, but I was asking what you guys want me to talk about, but you know, I wasn't specific enough, I guess. Yeah, I think I want to talk about the places that I went with my boyfriend so far. The places that we traveled together. But okay. Places that me and my boyfriend went to. And I will talk about why we fought. And I actually want to share the things that we fought about during our trip. You know, fighting during your vacation trips are the worst, but you know, sometimes it's not it is avoidable. It is avoidable, but you know, like, I always make it happen. So the first place that we ever went to outside of our state was Florida. We went to Orlando to visit the Universal Studios and just a bunch of places like that. What's all that called? Adventure, Universal. We didn't go to Disney World, but yeah, so I think we were there 3 full days, and we spent 2 days at the Universal Studio, because you know it's big, so you can, I think it takes about a couple of days to look at the whole thing. We went, and we, like, because we arrived in the morning, and we took, like, you know, we checked in and we were settling in, and we changed to clothes so we could head out to the Universal Studios. And I wore this really, really cute dress, okay? It's really thin dress. Actually, I have it. Hold on. So let me know what you guys think. If I can get out of this chair. So, I wore this dress. What do you guys think? So, I got this from Forever 21, like, 3 years ago. And when I was super skinny, it fit me, okay? Anyways, I can't even button it up now. But, so I decided to wear that to the Universal Studios. And I was like, oh my god, this is so cute. I'm gonna take so many photos. And he looks at me. He's like, you're gonna wear that? I'm like, yeah, why not? He's like, you know, we're gonna be riding roller coasters and all. I'm like, I know. I'm like, duh. And he's like, and you're gonna wear that? I'm like, yeah, I'm wearing it. Clearly, I'm wearing it right now. I'm ready to go. And he got really mad at me. Usually, when he's not happy about something, he will mention it, but he doesn't. He's like, whatever, dude, do whatever you want. But like, when I wore this, he was really, really mad. He's like, no, don't wear that, go change, whatever. I'm like, okay, jeez. But I don't actually really know why he was so upset. I don't know if he was upset because he didn't want Because, you know, like, when guys don't like to have girls wear, like, super short skirt or super short pants or something that shows their cleavage or boobs too much, you know, like, it's their girl. That's why they want to protect her. I don't know if it was that or I don't know if because, like, you're going to... Or because he kept saying, like, no one's going to be wearing that. No one's going to be wearing a dress to a Universal Park or, like, an amusement park. I'm like, yes, they will. Some girls wear more skanking things. And he's like, no, just go change. I don't know if he was embarrassed of me. I don't know what it was, but it was fine because I went out to get this dress before, like, our trip. And I bought this specifically for our trip, and he didn't let me wear it. So, but I ended up wearing it to our beach. The beach we went to. Which eventually worked out fine, but I was so pissed off. Ow. So what do you guys think? Was that unacceptable, like my boyfriend said? Was that like going overboard, or was my boyfriend just overreacting? Let me know in the comments so I could yell at my boyfriend. I'm almost done. But another reason why I fought. Oh, my stomach was at Colorado. So it was for our anniversary, I think. We went to Colorado. Our first year or second year, I don't know. We went. And so before I talk, I want to thank SG19 on Instagram. She asked me about my travels, and when I was thinking about my, so I'm like, okay, that kind of sounds fun, because I love traveling, and I think, and then when I was thinking about it, I'm like, oh my god, me and my boyfriend fought at least once at every trip, so I wanted to talk about that, but so thank you. Anyways, so me and my boyfriend were in Colorado. Okay, actually, it wasn't fighting, but I cried because first day we got there and we went to this hiking area, but you know, when we went to Colorado, it was there was snow. It wasn't snowing, but the hiking areas, like the mountains, you know, they have snow. They have a lot. Actually, they had a lot of snow there. So we're hiking, we were not prepared, he was wearing like Jordans or something, and I was wearing New Balance, just like regular gym shoes. We're like, okay, let's go hiking, it's gonna be fun, there's snow, you get to see some lake, like waterfalls, you know, like frozen waterfalls. We were excited, and we were ready to like climb up. We were climbing, and I realized that it was really dangerous because, you know, like, you know, when people walk over snow, it gets slippery. I don't know how to explain it, because they kept stepping on the same snow, like same path. It just gets slippery and it gets icy. And we were walking through there, we were just walking through those paths, and realized that there were no, like, rails, or, like, there's nothing to hold on to. We're like, this is kind of dangerous, because if you fall, like, you're dead, because we were all pretty high. And we're going up, and my boyfriend, being adventurous, I don't even know, but we kept going up and up and up. And at one point, I was so scared because there's nothing to hold on to. It gets slipperier, and I thought I was gonna die. I thought I was gonna die there. And going up was one thing, but going down was like, oh my god, it's the scariest thing in the world because it's so pretty. Like, if you slip, you just like go down, you just like literally slip through the mountains and you don't even know where you're gonna end up. So I was really scared, and my boyfriend didn't care. He kept like running down. He didn't even like, he wasn't even cautious. And I got really scared. I was scared for him, and as I was, and then I was like already behind him, and I was like, so I kind of bent down a little. I was grabbing onto like branches next to me so I wouldn't fall. And then he's like, come on, let's go, let's go. And then I got really scared and I started crying. He started laughing at me like, why are you crying? I'm like, I don't want to die. Oh my god, like, you're going, like, I don't want you to die, I don't want you to slip. And then he found it really funny, and I didn't find it funny. I was so scared for us that we're gonna end up dying, but he's like, it's okay, no, I got you, we'll just go down safely. I'm like, no, we should have came up here, we were not even prepared. And I kept crying. I was like holding onto a branch and like kind of like crunched down, like scrunched down. I'm like, oh my god, I'm so scared. My boyfriend and I went to Canada in a couple of weeks. Oh, it's gonna be a road trip, so which means we're gonna be in the car, just us two, for hours and hours and hours. So you'll find out what happens, and we might be fighting for our entire drive there, or we might be having fun. You don't know. Oh yeah, actually, one thing that I wanted to mention was, I stopped watching, but before I moved, I was really into this Netflix TV show called KEEMI, Unbreakable KEEMI. Really funny. It's so funny because, you know, that girl's name is KEEMI. Like, I mean, like, I know hers is spelled K-I-M-M-Y. Am I K-E-E-M-I? The only reason why I spell my name that way is because when I was creating the YouTube account, I saw so many like KEEMI, like K-I-M-M-Y, so I just spelled it differently. But yeah, if you guys never watched it, or if you guys still watch it, the KEEMI, that girl, basically gets trapped in like a bunk, like a underground bunk for 15 years because of this guy who's the leader of a cult. And she basically tells her that the world ended and you're the only ones who survived, like, God's mercy on us and blah blah blah. But, you know, obviously he was lying, and they get trapped for 15 years. And the police finds them. So she comes out of the bunk not knowing anything, not knowing how much the world changed, and she decides to live in New York. Basically, that's the like story of her life after being in the bunk for 15 years. So she doesn't know a lot of things. She is very behind, you know? But anyway, she meets this guy named Dong. D-O-N-G. It's like my boyfriend. Like, what are the coincidences, right? I thought it was like, I don't know. That's like one of the reasons why I kept watching it, because I thought it was really funny. I'm like, hey, it's like me and my boyfriend. But he's supposed to be Vietnamese in that show, but he's actually Korean, playing Vietnamese role. So I thought that was kind of funny. He's actually really cute too. I don't know, I heard that he's in different TV series, but it's my first time seeing him, but that was really cute. I thought he was really cute. But, so KEEMI has another, so anyways, the KEEMI, she has her sister, younger sister, has different, same mom, different father, I think. But her dad named her KEEMI. And then Kimmy's like, you mean KEEMI, like me. And then he's like, no, it's KEEMI. I don't know what to, so I think they spelled it differently. Did they spell it like K-I-M-I? I don't know, but I thought it was kind of funny because I saw some people pronouncing my name like that, like KEEMI instead of KEEMI. They say KEEMI, like KEEMI. Maybe it was my fault for spelling it like that, but I just didn't want to have same name as like other people. And KEEMI wasn't taken back then. I think that's one more account, but I don't know. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, my giveaway did end. I picked a person already and I am about to send the box. Please give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy this video, if you like this recipe. But definitely feel free to kind of like mess around with the recipe, because I know that it's most likely too spicy for like many of you guys. So feel free to like mess around with it and let me know how like you guys change it up, because you know, like my recipe was based off on someone else, and you know, I kind of adjusted to the way I like it. And another thing is, I will make sure to give more honest title to my videos, because I know that my previous one was misleading. And someone mentioned how it's really harmful to people who actually wants to get a good corn dog recipe, but you know, me, like it was my first time making it, and clearly it just did more of a harm than being helpful to that person. So I'm sorry about that. So I will make sure to be more honest or more clear with my titles. And another person said like they think that I should be better at making a dish before I can film it and show it to you guys. But I don't agree actually, because that's not what my show is about. Like I'm not, there are so many great people on YouTube that shares like great recipes and they're really good at cooking, but I know I'm not good at cooking. I know that my recipe is not original, my recipe is not perfect, but I film it because it's entertaining to watch, and because through the mistakes that I make, I think people can learn something from that too. So it doesn't always have to be like the perfect or the right way for people to learn the recipes. I feel like my channel is more about like what not to do, like for real, and get some ideas or and get entertained. Basically, I'm not, you know, like I love cooking, and I know that I'm not a great cook, or I'm not, you know, it's not like I have my own recipes. Like, you know, my recipes are all based off of something else, someone else's recipe. So that's not what I'm trying to prove here. I'm just trying to show you guys that anyone can cook and anyone can get an idea and create something that looks delicious. That's it. I know if people are bothered by the fact that like I show how to cook things when I clearly never made it before, I'm sorry if you feel that way, but that's not what my channel is about. It's more of eating, it's more of just cooking for fun. It's creating something that I would love to enjoy to eat. So I hope you guys understand that part. But I will try to adjust a lot of things, like the title of course, and I have been getting a lot of good feedbacks on the ASMR part, so thank you for that. And I feel like my room is echoing less, no? Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up. I will try to leave the ingredients and the recipes in the description box. Connect with me on different social medias. I love talking to you guys on Snapchat, because I love, some of them are just really funny. I love that. I'll see you guys in the next video. Subscribe for new videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. So yeah, thank you guys. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.